All right, we are back, turning in this quest. I had the wrong waypoint on, but here he is.
That's enough quacks to sustain the Googlide flipper with infinite ammunition. Goop says he was there when the Porky Puff took out of Date's leg, so this World Eater has made it personal. After that, Out of Date started using his head instead of his legs and came up with the plan on how to best make a stand against the World Eaters, and it wasn't by foot. He seems happy to talk. Claims it's refreshing to see someone dedicated to making things better, just like them. Hopes to see you again soon. He seems happy to talk. Says you should take care. It's a bridge. Just get over it. They've restroyed this area, muddied up what used to be muck. As if it wasn't bad enough before the tribe war began. That's the Jagni tribe's fort. Their friendship can be a blessing or a curse. It's up to you. You're either a part of their solution to the tribe war or part of the problem.
All right, let's go pee on a pole. Oops, my bad.
Let's see.
What am I going up? I have to climb up there to let them know that it's time to start. I guess. That's the way up we go.
They've been waiting for you. Taking control of this fort will bring peace between your tribes.
Yeah, but then there are two other tribes. Well, there are six tribes. I can't remember what tribes there are. How many tribes there are? Four or six.
Plan?
You better be. A tribe's fort is a bigger challenge than an outpost. They've positioned a storm tower near the fort that you'll use to get over the wall. However, you need to prop up its wheelhouse first to stabilize the situation. They've built the storm tower to protect and get you over the walls of the fortification while keeping an element of surprise. It's time to set the rival tribe free. Inflict as little damage as possible as you make your way through to their Sifu. You need to unite the tribes and save the Tree of Life to truly become free. A fire starter. The dry grass looks like it would ignite easily. You just need to create a spark to light a fire. It burns brighter than the light. That's a pyro sizzler right there. Just get to work on it. Make it frizzle. The battering bonker looks like a great way to get through the gate. Bet you just need to knock and it'll open up. That's bonkers. The Jagni tribe wants to become omnipresent and, most importantly, feared. They want to vanquish the tribes as the only way they can guarantee peace is through supremacy. He didn't expect it would go down this way. It'll be hard to talk your way out of a fight. He believes a fight won't settle who is right, just who's left. The rival Sifu is defeated, and the destiny of their tribe is in your hands. You are free to choose their fate, but not free from the consequences of your choice. He'll leave it up to you to decide the fate of the rival Sifu, but suggests you be merciful. Do good, and good will follow you. Thinks it's a good gesture to offer support to others when you can see that they need it. And with that, you're spinning your own fate, good or bad, never to be undone. Side by side they'll stand until order and stability is reinstituted. He wants you to focus. These are the new rival outposts your tribe needs to take control of. He says you'll regret not being on their side. The only way you'll learn their secrets, Wong Fu and the tribe weapon now, is if you defeat him. And that will never happen. Your Sifu is pleased. You're one step closer to uniting the tribes. It's a pity you needed to use force to get the point across. But he's still concerned about the fate of the world. You can't lose this war. If you get the ending wrong, the effort it took to get there was in vain. A proper ending, however, provides closure. He says you've grown so much stronger than when you first met. You know better than anyone that the fate of the world is still at stake. You need a world where everyone is guided only by their conscience. The fate of the world depends on the triumph of good. The Tree of Life still stands, and it's up to you to make sure it does so to the end. It's the Jagni staff. That's an improvement. Blisterboo, known for its perfect temperature and atmosphere. Look! A spiral groover from the long ago. An apparatus that plays mellow discs. Wouldn't be surprised if it still works. Looks like the groover's arm needs to be nudged to get the needle in position and hear the mellow disc's message. It's a Chi-Chi Bebop code memo. Good thing I'm old enough to decipher it. It sing-songs about a secret below-ground area, just a walkabout from here. Let's see. There's the sovereign who runs this outpost. He didn't expect his outpost to be invaded, but now that you're working with their rival, he can see why. He would have preferred if you could have solved this without violence. At least a peaceful solution has a chance, while a violent one never has. It's their last line of defense. Once their guardian falls, they'll surrender. The outpost belongs to your tribe now. He says you made them weaker, but they won't give up. Your Sifu thanks you. Your tribe is growing stronger. He says you did a great job capturing the outpost. Your one says you didn't have much of a choice.
Okay, the other two aren't that far away. So let's go get those. I'm not going to do 15 minutes though, probably, so I'm going to go ahead and pause it in between outposts. Record the outposts, and then probably save the fort for next time.
You've stumbled into the mushy-mosh mire, where the risk of getting forever stuck is omnipresent, regardless of whether you want it or not. There's a chug park over there. All sorts of chug-chugs call that place home. Go on, catch it. Let's see. Says they've been waiting for you to help. Just keep going while you can and don't stop until all outposts are under your control. There is a high boom team ready to help with taking over that outpost, but it seems their arc shooter is busted. Seems happy to hear the arc shooter will be dropping high booms down on the outpost quick like. Found a crossway. Now, which way to go? Get up there and get fixing.
Yeah. Oh, okay, give me a minute.
All fixed up. The arc shooters are already gearing up the high booms. Hope their aimers are fixed too. The outpost belongs to your tribe now. He says you made them weaker, but they won't give up. Your Sifu thanks you. Your tribe is growing stronger. He says you did a great job capturing the outpost. You're one step closer. Says you're in good company there.
Okay, hold on a minute. Okay, well, the last outpost, we'll have to wait. Till next time. Please like, subscribe, and click the bell if you need to. Thanks for watching.